somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me.
Time to take it apart. Here's where we start. Get something and pull these little clips out with. I just used a bolt pushing to the side right there. The little side that's locked in, and when it pushes under, just bloop, bloop, pop them puppies off. Gather them up. Store them somewhere. There they are. Pieces for the other side. Here we go. Now those are off. Look at this. We can take these things off. A water guard. Just gotta kind of switch them to the side a little bit. They pop right off. You can see. Just twist, twist. Pop right off. Then we're gonna gather these up. And we're gonna put them in the pile too. I'm gonna put them in a bucket and save them as extra parts in case I ever want to reconvert this thing back to a rat rack, which is totally possible, as long as you save the little square pieces that you cut off. We'll get to that later. There they are. And we're back at it. All right, next pieces. We're gonna take these little pieces off and back to the water lines. Just pull right out, slide off. Wiggle them back and forth, and boop, pop right off. Easy peasy all day long. I'll say that one gets hard. Anyway, then this thing will pull out. The food trough, you can take it, set it to the side somewhere. It's an unneeded part for this conversion. Kind of got a stack there. This is the second one I've done. And you got your line, look, extra food that you've caught up in the thing. You're gonna gather everything up, throw it over here in the pile. Ah, here we go, we gotta get this damn metal thing off. It's held on pretty good too. There we go. Pull it off and set it to the side in the pile. Save it, whatever you want to convert it back. Pull the line off. Throw it in the pile. There it is. Woo! Got a piece to pile. Get these little clips. Those. Water line, or the water holder. I can use them on the rest of my rat rack. I got a whole nother rat rack, so this one is just small that I got in a trade. Kind of see through the shadow there and gathering them up. There they are. The clips and the water nozzle. Now we're down to removing these clips. You want to save these. We're going to reuse these. Okay, there's five of them per row. I just found these rat tubs to be way too small for my Norwegians. Get rid of that food. Let's see. There we go. Just pull on this a little bit. A little jammed in there. Really needs to be cleaned. Pull it out. There's one. There's two. There we go. Yeah, they're just sliding right out real easy. I've already pre-ordered all the stuff I needed for the snake rack, which is basically the top liners that slide right back in there, and the heat bar. I can just put a water cup in there. Use the same tubs even. Put these over here. All my work stuff over there. So there those are. I'm gonna save those. Yeah, gonna save those. I'm gonna set those up here. And I'm gonna wash. Gonna scrub this puppy. Gotta get it clean. You're gonna wanna save these. That'll be a later video. That little bottom piece. Just knock them out. Something long. Like a screwdriver, so I'm gonna hammer and they tap right out. Anyway, here we go. Time to clean this puppy. Didn't work. I was hoping it would just automatically clean itself. I'm going to fast forward through some of this. And it's just clean. I don't want to sit and watch and see. I wetted it down real good. And wipe them off first. soak him, let him sit in the sun for a minute. Let him dry. And then we'll get to the actual parts where we gotta cut a little off and get these down to the right size, because it sits really high, but it does cuts right down to size. I mean, all you'd have to order to reprint it back to a rat rack is more end pieces that plug in, put them back together, put everything reversed back together, and it's pretty much convertible. You can, I guess it'd be like a, you know, like a transformer. It can either be a rat rack or it can be a snake rack. No, this thing has more uses than, you know, like, I don't need it in my snake stuff. I can pull it apart, put it back together with a rat rack, no problem. I'm just spraying out the end pieces, I think, right here. Just kind of making sure they're soaked. That F10 disinfectant. Right here, I'm getting ready to mark the 4 3/4 down. Yeah, right there, 4 3/4, yeah. I'm gonna mark it right here. Four and three quarters. Yes, sir. 4 3/4. Get a mark on all four sides and then I'll mark them around. This is for the baby snakes. This is an F10, basically, of the 1075 Freedom Breeder Rack. Showing my skills. Anyway, I'll put a few lines on here. Alright, I'm gonna bring it over now. Basically, I'm just marking it all the way around. The whole piece of square tubing so everything lines up, looks good. Gotta kind of make your cuts really, really nice on these, so just take your time if you're gonna do this as well. Yeah, it didn't work for me as a rat rack. It was too small. And so, yeah, here you are. I'm just marking it all the way around with my square. I marked one side before just so that I had it where I wanted it. I'm just going to go through and mark all the way around before I start cutting everything so everything looks good. Oh, I guess I'm ready to start cutting. Time to cut, baby. Yeah. Get to it. I would just cut back and forth, you know, just nice and slow and even, and take your time. It'll cut. You see, I'm just going back and forth, nice and easy. Following my lines. Nice and steady. Easy does it. There it is right there. Yeah, it's all the way through. And yeah, just take your time and go down the next line. That's why you want to mark it all the way around. Make sure everything connects. And that way when all your lines are cut, everything looks good. It'll fit together the way it's supposed to. Hey, don't be in a hurry, just nice and slow and take your time. Sparks look kind of cool. Yeah, I'm gonna speed it up through here. Now flip it over. Do the same thing to this side. Follow your lines. Nice and easy. Easy does it, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Yep, buzz, buzz, buzz. Look at the lights. Look at the sparklers. Gotta keep out for fires where I live too, so it's like, wet everything down before you go. If you're in an area where there's fire, wet everything down before you grind. The sparks are a couple thousand degrees. And wear safety glasses, of course. Get to this leg here. And all those legs will be 4 3/4 inches. Yeah, I've almost got this, and then I just got it to deburr. Cut the bottom line real quick. I didn't have very good angle with the camera for it, but you get the gist of what I'm doing. I'm cutting my lower line right there, my grinder, little peanut grinder, DeWalt battery operated, no cord needed. Yay! Alright, yeah, speed up. Flip it over. I think I just started deburring right here. I'm cutting the last two. Yeah, I'm cutting the last two. Saw the sparks jump up there. Now I'm deburring a little bit. Yeah, I'm deburring. Jump to this side, do the same thing. Kind of run the grinder up and down a couple times just to make it nice and smooth. That way it doesn't cut me the instant I plug it all back together. All four sides on all four sides. That's right, 16, baby. Deeper. Jing, jing. Deeper. And time to put the legs back into it. When I did this, I wanted to do it with the square part going into the bottom. And the tapered part with the lines in it right here, that's the tapered part right there. And that's the square part. You want that square part down. And I do have an anvil right back here. I'll indicate it in the next couple of shots. Anyway, you just want to slide that in there where it sticks in nice. Get yourself a hammer. Set it on something solid and just kind of tap it down real lightly. It'll go in. Easy peasy. When any little bits might peel up, you just wipe them off. Then flip it over and repeat. There we go. Get that little sucker to stick in there a little bit. Get it to stick in there a little bit. Get your hammer and just tap it right in. I'm not hitting it very hard. I'm just tapping it. Wiping off the excess pieces of plastic that shaved off from the inside. The beauty of it is the inside's going to be, you know, with that piece in there, not going to be sharp to the outside because you deburred the outside. That's why. Once you get that in there, it's sealed up. I'm going to set this to the side. See, there's the anvil right there. Woo, back this way. Where am I going with this? Oh, one last cleaning after I did everything. I wanted to wipe it down one last time. Make sure I get it good and clean. Sprayed it down with F10. And, oh, there's the anvil symbol. A little late. Yeah, just spray it down. There it is. One more wipe down. Yeah, this was the final wipe down. Really soak everything really good to kill anything that was in there. Sterilize that mother. This is kind of one of my longer videos. Appreciate you if you've made it this far. Thank you. Yeah, go ahead and tell me in the comments if this is something that that you would think about doing. Yeah, I'm just wiping it down real good one last time. I figured I could always convert it back if I need to. I mean, four pieces of plastic, I've got all the supplies for both. It really wasn't that expensive to convert into a snake rig. You know, with the wait time and everything. It was like I instantly had 15 more spaces for snakes, for baby snakes. Yeah, just about there now. Got it all wiped down. I think I'll flip it over and do that. Had to clean the shit out of the tracks. They were full of rat food and like where water dissolved some of the rat food. You know, so I needed a really good wipe down, spray out. It's kind of cool. It was the first time I got to check out these new Freedom Breeder Pro Series line. Not bad, not bad. I do like the Classic myself a little better because of the metal, but they're not bad. I like them. I might even just order 15 more tubs, 15 new tubs, and then, I don't know, do something with the old ones. Yeah, installing the top inserts right here. Just gonna slide them in one at a time. They slide right into the same slot, same size. Everything's perfect. Perfect. Installing the old clips that I said hold on to. Don't need to put them in the bucket for storage. There it is. Snake, baby snake ready. There goes Trinity. And another snake room. Here's the overview underneath. High five. Knuckles. Back outside. Well, there it is. Slip the tubs in. Ready for baby snakes. Throw a cup in there. I got one left to do. There it is. Shebang. Conversion complete. Rat rack to snake rack. Sweet. 15 new places to put babies. Thanks for watching. Have a good one, everybody.